Hello and welcome back to WC Marketplace. Today's video will be all about commission management in WCMP. While having a flexible commission structure gives you the advantage of applying various kind of commission, and keeping track of this commission is also important. In this video, we shall be learning how you can track and manage commissions. Before we get started, please do not forget to watch our videos on levels and types of commission, the link of which will be provided in the description box below. This is important because it will give you a bit of clarity on how commission works. Let us learn how and from where the commission can be viewed and managed by the admin. In this video, we will also see how the vendors can view their commission amount from the respective dashboard. To view or keep track of commissions from the admin dashboard, hop onto WCMP menu and from there select the commission submenu. Once the commission page loads, you will be able to view title. The commission title is displayed here. Order ID. The order ID on which you will receive the commission is given. Product. The product ID on which you will receive the commission is also provided. Vendor. The name of the vendor who will receive the commission is displayed. Amount. The amount is given. Net earnings. Your net earning from the sale of this product is provided. Status. The commission statuses is displayed here, like whether it is paid or unpaid. Date. The date on which the commission is received is given. Admin can also manage commissions by selecting a particular commission and choose the edit option. Once selected, the following details will appear. With the commission ID, you can view the associated vendor email address and the status of the commission. Under the general tab with the order details, the order status is also viewed. All the details of the vendors are viewed under the Vendor Detail tab. The Commission Data tab contains all the commission amount that the admin is supposed to receive, with the shipping and the tax. The commission status of the particular order can be changed from the drop-down menu. Let's look closely at each commission statuses one by one. Paid. When the commission amount is successfully paid to the vendor. Unpaid. By default, whenever the commission is not transferred to the vendor's account, the status is shown unpaid. Refunded. This commission status is reflected when the customer initiates a refund for a particular product and you decide to pay the entire refund value. Partial refunded. This is applicable if either you or the vendor choose to pay part of a refund amount. Reverse. Whenever the admin changes the commission statuses from the processing or complete to pending, refund, failed or cancelled, then the commission statuses gets changed to reverse. Though this settings is useful for those who uses WCMP 3.4 version. For this commission, why don't we change the commission statuses to paid and see the type changes? Was not that simple? Now let us take a look at how vendors who receives the commission manage them. Once the payment process is completed, vendor receives their commission amount on their dashboard. Depending on the payment method selected by them, they can either request a commission withdrawal or wait for automatic disbursement. Meanwhile, vendors can view the details of commission by going to the vendor dashboard and then navigating to the payment menu option. Under the payment menu, the history submenu would appear. On the history page, vendors can view date, the date on which the vendor received his payment, order ID. This is the identification number of the order on which the vendor received his commission. Transaction ID. The vendors can use this identification number to view the transaction details of the commission he has received from the admin. Commission ID. This is the identification number by which a vendor can track his commission. Fee. Here the vendor can view the amount charged for requesting a withdrawal. after he runs for fee withdrawal request. Net earnings. This is the total amount he has earned after completing an order request. With this, we have come to the end of our video. If you like the tutorial, then do not forget to like, share and subscribe to our channel. Click on the small red bell to get notified whenever we post a new video. And do not forget to check out the description box below for more useful links. Thank you for watching.